We are going to talk about probably the most important thing you need to get right to make your footage look really good, and that's skin tones. I'm going to show you my process. We are in Resolve. This is footage of a girl on a camping trip, just chilling in the mountains. First step, I'm going to show you my project settings. I work in a color space, ARRI log C3. The output color space is Rec 709A. The first step of any project, change the color space to the timeline you are working on. Color space transform, chuck it in there. I change it from red to ARRI. Step 2. Now I need to change it from ARRI to Rec 709. ARRI, Rec 709 with another color space transform. Boom. All the editing, all the color work is going to happen in here. If I change it here, I'm changing it in Rec 709. There's less data, less information to play around with here. Way more in here. Right click, add serial. I'm going to use the panel I have right in front of me. I'm playing with the gamma, the gain, a little bit of contrast, and the saturation. The skin already looks really nice, to be honest. This footage is very good. It's well shot. Okay, I'm going to make another node, and this is going to be where I retouch the skin. If you want to see if the skin tone is in the right area, you are going to use your vectorscope. You see this line right here? That is the skin tone indicator. If you do not see this, you need to go here. Make sure it says skin tone indicator. You check it. Now I want to isolate this, window this. Can't window it in here. I need to wind it in here because that's actually what we are seeing. I'll actually show you. So if I go here and I go here and I say, I'm going to go here. I'm going to make a window over my face. I just want to see where those colors are. And I go to this guy, magic wand. I'm just seeing that color, right? I'm seeing that. It's pretty saturated on the line. I'm going to turn this node off. If I do exactly the same thing here, and I do exactly the same thing here, now you see it's really washed out. Like, can you even see that? If I go back to this one, it isn't washed out. Because of this, we are here still working in the log. It's still going to be a washed out image because it hasn't been transformed to Rec 709 yet. So to check your skin tone, you need to check it after it gets turned into Rec 709. But you want to make changes in here because you have more information. So the skin is nice. That is good. I'm going to reset this node. If we feel like the saturation on the skin isn't good, we don't want that. Make the change in this guy. We can just select skin tones here and then we can decrease it. So we want to park it there. There you go. You have your skin tones. If you run into this problem, okay, so this is kind of advanced skin tone advice. If you run into the problem where you feel your skin tones are too saturated, but when you decrease it, your subject kind of feels like they're dying. Sometimes the skin tones are correct, but it's the environment around it that isn't. So if your skin tones are around here, it's usually correct. If it doesn't feel like it fits into this footage, what I like to do is look at surrounding environment. So I'm going to add a node. I'm going to leave her skin tone there, but I'm going to change what's around her. And you'll see that actually improves the image because the skin is going to sit in that image way better. So let's go here, here, and there. Disable. In this image, her skin is the most saturated thing. Here, everything else is a bit more saturation, so the whole image makes more sense. If you see people, right, you see people walking around, people's skin aren't the most saturated thing you see. That's why when you look at images or footage where the skin really jumps out, it feels weird. So that's the one thing that can help you with skin tones. Another thing that's also really important I see people do with skin tones, and if you kind of fiddle around with it and you can't really get it where you want to, is that do not make your skin one color. What I mean with this is, if you look at skin tones, you have blood vessels in there. So you actually need different hues in the skin. If you make the skin look uniform, it looks unnatural. So try not over edit the skin, and it's okay if it kind of, I wouldn't say it's blotchy, but should be a little bit of variation in color. And if you play around with that and grade a lot of footage, after a while, your eye is going to pick up what feels good and what doesn't. You're going to get like an instinct to feel when your skin fits nicely in your environment and in your footage.